am Dr. Romano, professor of organic chemistry here at Romano Scientific New York, and the creator of the DAT Destroyer book, along with the Orgoman products. I am here today with one of my former students who actually took the DAT exam four times.
Yes, I did.
Is that right, Mr. Buzz?
Yes, I did. That is
four
the truth.
Times. You heard that right. It's probably one of the biggest success stories that I personally have ever seen, where a student on the fourth try actually hit it out of the ballpark. Vas, if you can just tell us a little about this journey that you've been
Hi,
on.
Hi, my name is Vasil. Many of you may know me as Vas. Yes, I did take the DAT four times. Fourth time for me was the charm. Hopefully it's not that for you. I wish all of you to have much of a quicker journey. I knew that since young age that I wanted to become a dentist. I think my mother came for an appointment at one point, and I was, I think, 6 years old. And in Europe, the lab was almost in the back of where you would seat the patient. And there was a really old school dentist, and I was missing. And my mother said, "Oh my God, where's my kid?" And they found me. I was smelling the eugenol in the back.
Wow. What do you get on the previous stats, if you don't mind me asking?
I would get 19s on
the bio. It's still not bad. It's still within range.
Yeah.
And what did you get in the chemistries on your first one or two attempts?
On the chemistry, surprisingly, on Orgo, I did get an 18 for the first time.
Still not bad.
And then in general chemistry was a 15. I mean, I did not like general chemistry. I actually, I think I could do a KSP problem in my sleep.
But because you see, these numbers that you guys are hearing, 15s, 17, 18, you're in the ballpark. You're not that far off. A 15 or a 17 or an 18 is not going to get you to dental school, but you're at least within that range that if you can put together a few more problems, you can easily get yourself to the 19 or 20. And that's why if you knew all the Destroyer book, I think you would agree you can get into the 20s comfortably.
I focused more on like reading and understanding what I got wrong and looking at those problems again. I kept a tally of what I did not understand. So I would type up all the numbers of all the questions, and I would answer the question. I would do many problems from each section, and I would, for example, mark myself how many I got wrong, and heavily focused on those that I got wrong, and made sure I was, you know, very comfortable with that subject.
Well, what did you get in the bio?
I got 26 in the bio.
26 is absolutely blazing. I mean,
I
got 26.
Your entire bio notes. I took my own notes, wrote out what I knew that I was not either going to remember or what I was not comfortable with. And then I said, oh, I might forget this, even though I know
For a guy that comes from the Ukraine, yeah. How many languages do you
speak? I speak five languages.
Okay, five languages. I mean, I'm lucky I speak English. And you got a 20.
I got a 20.
I think that's unbelievably incredible. I have a lot of students who are from other countries. I have a lot of students that are here from Korea, Japan, and I see like 28s. 29s in the sciences, but a lot of them told me when it came to the English section or the reading section, I'm seeing 14s and 15s. And that's not unusual that I see, where you just hit a 20, which I think is better than some of the students where English is the native language.
I read the articles that you would post. You would post them around 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock in the morning.
8 a.m. every morning.
8 a.m.
Absolutely.
So,
right. So
I already, by that point, did like an hour and a half of studying bio or orgo or gen chem. So that was my break. And my good friend Mina from Rutgers, who was an active member of your study group, and he was the one who told me about these readings before I even came to your class. And I would religiously, like, it became my religion, as fanatically crazy as it sounds. I would wake up, do what I had to do, and then that was my break. I would read the two or three articles that you would post, and then I started to think. I started to time myself. I would give myself no more than 6 minutes per that article.
I mean, I saw something in Vas that I believed in, but my biggest job, I think, was not really to show them the organic chemistry or the gen chem, but to make you believe you can do it.
Yes.
And I knew you can do it, but I just had to make you believe you can do it. And once that happened, that's when I knew we were successful. Because towards the end, you began to believe. I saw you in that study group, and you were focused. And you know, I'm not one for effusive praise on students.
I want to say to the students that will continue to be in touch with you and truly engage in the conversation with you, meaningful conversation. So I want those of you who sit on the other side of this screen and say, oh, he's too scary, I can't ask him a question. You're foolish. I'm sorry to say that.
It's not to be scared about. You're not grown up. Nothing to be scared about. Absolutely, I'm on your team.
You have not grown up to seize this moment of opportunity because it's a huge opportunity. I saw Dr. Romano, his books and his classes and the people around him, including Nancy Steen, as a source of inspiration because Nancy would say all the time, she would say, you have to think 30. You have to think 30. And that was another thought that I brought with myself to the room where I was studying. I really did not accept the fact that I was not going to become a dentist. In my mind, that was always in the back of my mind, I will do it. And every day that I was studying, I kept saying to myself, how do you step up? How do you change today, this morning at 5:30 a.m. or 6 a.m. that I would start studying? How do you change your habits today? What did you not like yesterday? So that was in my mind every day. If there is someone in your life who that you are surrounded by, who tells you that you can do it, you need to find the right people to support you.
And I do remember you telling me one time that you had teachers saying, you know, you're not going to be able to make this. And I have to admit, in class, this was a good student. And I was sort of scratching my head that this is not that bad of a guy. You know, he took it three times already. You know, normally you think it to yourself a fourth time, it's not going to matter that much. But the kid was focused.
Why not the DAT Destroyer sooner?
I spent so much money. I got lured into the timed exams, basically. And so I put all my faith into the timed exams. I would just practice them. And to tell you the truth, the fourth time when I was studying, I found them rather childish. I'm sorry to say that. And they weren't giving me what I wanted to get out of the material.
Two-part question. One, did you think of yourself specifically as having an additional obstacle to overcome as English being the second language? And other people as immigrants or English as a second language, what would you say to them to keep them encouraged throughout the process?
Yes, this is a very interesting question. Initially, I thought that English is an obstacle to my success. However, one day, I don't know how it happened, I said to myself, I have been in this country for over 10 years, and I shouldn't be falling back on that. It was very irresponsible, in my opinion, for me to live with that for about 3 years. So I said to myself, no, it's not a language barrier. In the beginning, it was, but I crossed that. I practiced and I persevered. I read and I did what I had to do. Main thing for me was repetition, doing things that you were not comfortable with. The first time I took the DAT, I sort of shied away from things I was uncomfortable with, and that's not a good thing. You'll do a crown one day, and you're gonna be, I don't feel comfortable, I'm just gonna, you know, rush it off. It's not a good thing.
What's your favorite thing about Dr. Romano?
That he's honest. I like that, yeah. If you can't accept that, you have to grow up and then accept that. And you have to put in the work. I remember when we were finishing the class and I was telling you about all the people who mention your name at Rutgers. They call you Jim Jim, by the way. They say, you gotta go to Jim Jim. You gotta go to Jim Jim. Listen to him. Jim Jim will help you. And I don't know who coined that.
I don't know either. But
I'm sorry about that if that makes you unhappy.
No.
What's your favorite thing about Boz?
His personality is a lovable guy. There's not one kid in the class that didn't love us. He's tough, though. He's a little tough sometimes, that if you're talking, he will actually say to you, excuse me, you got to be quiet now. But everyone respected us.
How would it be different, do you think, for someone who isn't able to go to Dr. Romano's class in person versus just using the materials?
Oh, participate in the study group. Never had a problem with asking a question. I never had a problem with Dr. Romano answering a question. I mean, you're also, I loved the math videos, and I loved the biology videos, and I absolutely loved the gen chem. Like, before the test, I think a week and a half before my test, I watched all the videos.
Wow, nice.
And I liked all of them. So when you guys do watch them, give it credit, like it, and share it with other students, because good things deserve to be praised.
And what is your message to Voss moving forward from here on out?
Do nothing different than what you've done. You've done the game plan, you executed, and you carried it out. That's what you got to do.
Thank you.
Do nothing different. Just everything that you've done, you've just stayed so focused. Just continue on with that focus, and that'll carry you through. That's my best advice to him.
Thank you.
And usually I would say, let's do something different. Nothing different. You're right on target. I have nothing but the strongest praise for this guy. This guy's a winner.
Thank you.